In this video, you'll learn how to generate a robot machining program using RoboDK. In this example, we are exporting a generic 5-axis machining program from RhinoCam. You can post all machining operations as one file and open them in RoboDK. You can see that each machining operation is automatically split in RoboDK as a robot machining project. You can also see that a KUKA cell was loaded by default with the machining program. This happens because we posted the file from RhinoCam using a custom BAT file. You can select Update on the robot machining project or bulk select your toolpaths and choose Update Programs. In this example, everything seems to work using the default settings, and you could directly generate the robot programs by selecting Generate Robot Program. But let's say you want to use another robot, such as an ABB robot. You can easily replace a robot by right-clicking on the robot and selecting Replace Robot. You can then choose a robot you have in your library. However, for this example, I'll show you how you can build a new robot cell for robot machining. You can open the online library by selecting this button. You can also access the library by selecting File, Open Online Library. You'll have access to over 500 robots from over 50 different robot manufacturers. You can find your robot by using the filters such as filtering by brand and looking for a 20 kg payload robot and a reasonable reach. Selecting the download button will open the robot in your project. Each robot will be loaded with its own robot base as a coordinate system. You can also load 3D models such as STEP, IGES, or STL files, among other formats. To open a new file, you can drag and drop them in RoboDK or select File Open. You can create a new coordinate system by selecting the corresponding button in the toolbar or by selecting the program menu. You can then place the objects you loaded attached to this new coordinate system by drag and dropping them within the tree. If you load the 3D model of your tool, you can drag and drop the object to the robot within the tree, and RoboDK will automatically convert it to a tool. The tool is automatically snapping on the robot flange because the 3D model was exported with respect to this coordinate system. You can also double-click the tool and select more options to move the geometry if needed. However, the most important part is to properly define the TCP, which should be the tip of the milling tool or the tool holder. In this example, the TCP has already been defined, but you can enter the coordinates of the tool if you have them. You can choose among different vendor-specific orientation formats to enter the tool pose. If you have an ABB robot, you probably have quaternion values. By holding the Alt key, you can move the robot or any coordinate system. By holding the Alt and Shift keys, you can modify the position and orientation of your TCP. So you should see the coordinates of your TCP being updated as you move it. You can follow a similar procedure with the coordinate system. So if you have a coordinate system that represents the world coordinate system, you can double-click on it and set the coordinates to 0, or simply select Reset. You should then see the objects at the origin of the station. In this example, since we have one robot, this coordinate system will match the base of the robot. You can also add another coordinate system that represents the machining reference. This is the reference that we usually define with the robot and allows us to locate the part. You can rename the items in the tree by pressing F2 or right-clicking and selecting Rename. If you attach the coordinate system to the robot base or not, it can make a difference if the robot base is not at the origin of the cell. So when you double-click a coordinate system to enter the coordinates, you should make sure you're providing them with respect to the correct reference. This is usually the robot base. By holding the Alt key, you can move the coordinate system where you want it, if you have the chance to choose where you'll place the part. You can double-click the robot to see what tool and coordinate system you're using. Make sure to select the correct tool and reference that you're planning to use for robot machining. With any robot setup, it is important to properly define the tool and reference frame that you're using for your toolpaths. This allows you to achieve good accuracy results. For a given position of the robot, the values you see in the robot panel should match the same values you see in your robot controller. Once you have built your robot cell, you can save it as one RDK file by selecting File, Save Station. This will save all the settings, including the 3D models, as one file. Once the robot cell is ready, you can load the machining file in RoboDK, and RoboDK should automatically create one robot machining project for each operation. You can select Update to see if RoboDK can find a feasible path using the default settings. You can also update all operations in bulk. We now have a valid simulation to perform 5-axis robot machining with this ABB robot. Once you have a valid program, you can right-click on it and select Generate Program. This will generate the files required by your robot controller. If you have an ABB robot, you'll notice that by simply generating the main program, you'll get all the machining operations defined in the same file. You'll also see that the first program that the controller executes automatically is the one called Main. This is specific to ABB robot controllers. One detail we could improve in this example is to change the orientation of the tool for the last two operations. To do so, you can simply grab the blue round arrow holding the Alt key. This allows you to rotate around the Z-axis of the tool. Once you move the tool to an orientation you'd like to have, simply select Teach in the robot machining settings. If the result gives you what you expected, you can copy the settings and paste them in another toolpath. You can then run the main program again to update the path and see the result. Another detail we could improve is to make the robot move to an approach position after each machining operation. To do so, you can move the robot to a safe position and create a new program. RoboDK automatically adds the join move instruction to the new program and creates a target recording the current position of the robot. You can rename the program by pressing F2 to something like go home. You can then make the robot move to this home target between each machining operation. Make sure to select Escape to stop the program if you can't add instructions. You can copy-paste this instruction within your program to quickly obtain the final result. You can right-click the program and select Display Path to see the robot toolpath as a yellow line. This will help you visualize if the position of your approach target is suitable for your project. In this example, we didn't add the 3D model of the part, but you can simply load the 3D model in RoboDK and place it in the machining reference.